name is Neven Steinmetz, and I'm 31 years old out of Boulder, Colorado. I've been racing professionally for 4 years now. I race downhill and the gated events, so four cross and dual slalom. Four cross is my forte, and I've been working really hard to bring downhill up to speed as well. So this year my goals are I'm heading over to Europe to do some World Cup racing. They build some really great four cross tracks on the World Cup level, so they're a lot of fun to ride and race. And their downhill tracks are out of hand, so it's going to be really fun. I got a new sponsor for this year, Ellsworth, with doing the Project Pink, which I'm really excited about. It's kind of it's a personal thing to be on the Project Pink program. My paternal grandmother had breast cancer, so it's definitely personal for me to be part of this program. I'm really excited about it. Going to be rocking pink all year long. My jersey.
What do you mean you're rocking pink?
Rocking pink. I'm even rocking pink today. We got Project Pink undies going on for race day, so it's pink all around here on the bike. Getting the jerseys all pink, so it's gonna be good.
Superstitions. Is there
any race superstitions? You know, I feel like a lot of people get into them, and then if you're not able to accomplish that, then your head's in the wrong place. So I've worked pretty hard to not have a pre-race superstition, so maybe that's one in and of itself, I'm not sure. But just try and stay focused. I do a lot of yoga, so at the top of the course, I try and do a little bit of meditative stuff just to kind of get in a calm frame of mind. And I think if you get all tight and worried, then that translates into your race run. And when your race run's only 2.5 minutes to maybe 5 minutes long for downhill, like, you don't have time to be stressed out, because with cross country you can sort that out and spend at least an hour and a half calm. But for the downhill and four cross, I mean, it's like maybe 30 seconds or up to 5 minutes, and you don't have time for that. So you have to be calm out of the gate and then just pedal your heart out. So.
And how many times a week do you train, and how many hours do you put in?
Times a week. Generally every day something, whether it's out doing a long base mile ride or doing sprint training. Like I said, I do a lot of yoga, so, and a lot of hot yoga, which is actually really physically intensive. That's gotten me through a lot of our winter in Boulder, where we've had a lot of snow on the ground. But I think it's helped prepare me in a lot of other ways. It's really good with stability and balance, which translates really well on the downhill track as well. If I'm not doing a hard ride, I'm usually out trying to at least do recovery or working on just little skills like manualing or riding wheelies, bunny hopping, all things that some people take for granted. But if you're out on the downhill track and there's something in your way and you know how to do those things, then it works out a lot better. So.
And what do you want to say to all the women and young girls out there who love you and who are watching?
I would just say, if you have the desire to do it, there are other girls out there that have that same desire. Meet up with them and ride. Like, don't always go with your boyfriend or your brother or your dad, because they ride differently than girls do, and it makes a big difference. So, yeah, find girls to ride with. You guys can encourage each other. I didn't have anyone get me into this sport. Most people have their story. Their dad or their boyfriend or their brother got them into this sport, and I didn't. I just decided I wanted to race mountain bikes, and I'm not really sure how or why, but I got into it, and I love it. I love it so much. I don't know what else I would ever want to do. Even when I'm done racing, I will still be riding mountain bikes.